Get ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Robert Walden, Brett Summers, Cher Nelson Riley, Elaine Joyce, Bill Daly, and George Beautifont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Ritter.
Okay. You're all right. I thank you for showing up and thank you for tuning in.
Thank you for showing up.
Thank you. Yeah.
I want you to show America what a Clark Gable back is. You have one
on.
Oh,
yes. This is one of the new batch.
That's a Clark Gable
back. Let me just sneak over here so I can see the monitor as they're getting a shot of it. Oh, that is a Clark Gable bag. Yeah, thank you.
Are you smart?
Get your head out of the way, would you?
Of course, there it's Carol Lombard's front.
It's Carol Lombard's front. Look at these crazy pockets they built.
These pockets
there.
Are
funny. That's
I don't know.
1937.
It's Colleen Moore.
No, it's not. It's Carolyn Jones.
Carolyn Jones.
That's Carolyn Jones.
Carolyn Jones. Who?
Cher.
And I said it was close, but not really.
Cher.
I think it's Sunny. A little more Sunny.
Can the camera get this?
Yeah.
That is my Sylvester Stallone front.
Oh. I don't want to see any more. Okay. Let's say hello to our two players here, Adrienne Carney and Ginger Morris.
Applause.
All right. Let us reacquaint ourselves with these two ladies, Ginger.
Yes.
Hello.
Hi. Hi, everybody.
Now, you're the lady wrestler, right?
Yes. Only on the floor.
Only on the floor?
That's it. Not standing up.
What have I started? No, just briefly tell us again.
Well,
where
I'm a professional dog trainer. I'm originally from Washington, D.C., and I live in beautiful Brea.
Okay. And Adrienne?
I am from Washington, D.C. I'm visiting, and I am a drama student at Catholic University.
Right. Yes, that's a. It's nice to be here. We are actually in the month of, at this moment that we're doing this show, it is August. And August is a very difficult month in Washington, D.C. What I mean is it's hot as hell there. That's
right.
All right, we're in the middle of round one here, and that means, Adrienne, we have this question for you. The frog said, ribbit, 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 ribbit.
That certainly is a frog.
Ribbit. That princess was the worst. Ribbit, ribbit. Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit. Ribbit. Ribbit.
That bad, huh?
Not only did she give me a kiss, ribbit.
Oh, God.
She gave me a blank.
Oh. Now, the frog is saying this about the princess?
Yes.
Oh, I love it.
I know.
That princess was the worst. Not only did she give me a kiss, she gave me a blank.
Can't imagine.
They're having a little trouble
with
it. First round questions, round one questions are a little tougher. So here we go. The frog said, ribbit. That princess was the worst. Ribbit, ribbit. Not only did she give me a kiss, ribbit, she gave me a...
wart.
Wart. Okay. Turnabout is fair play, according to Adrienne. What do you say, Robert?
I don't know how many frogs this lady's
Robert,
been
ribbit.
With, but I'll say disease.
A disease. Ribbit.
The penicillin kid here. What are you doing?
Okay.
Not only did she give me a what?
Kiss.
Kiss.
She gave me
one more wart.
Wart.
One
more wart. Ready? Ribbon. Ribbon.
6 years of this. Hickey.
Hickey is a good one.
Better than wart. Wart is the winning answer.
Wart match, but hickey is not a bad idea.
All right, it's all right. I just want you to keep it
because sometimes that happens
there,
when you
Mr.
kiss, doesn't it? Occasionally.
Yes, and then they wash off in the shower.
Oh. Really?
No, of course they don't.
Oh.
You like that?
Yes. Not only did she give me a kiss, ribbit, she gave me a...
wart.
Oh, okay, Bill Daly.
I was going to say Montgomery Ward, but she gave me a hickey. Sorry about that.
Hickey.
Oh, let's hear it for hickey.
Now, there's Carolyn Jones over there with a
wart.
Wart on her face.
A wart.
A wart. Okay. Round two, Adrienne, you're ahead. We'll ask you to go first. It's 3-0.
I'll try A this time.
A, okay.
He's doing Victor jokes.
Sorry.
Okay.
Very good. That silence always works.
The plot thins.
The ventriloquist's wife said, I'll tell you why I'm divorcing my husband. Last night at a party, he embarrassed me. He threw his voice and it came out of my bling.
I don't write.
Use your head. Steal. That's the only way to get ahead in life.
It's Hollywood.
Okay, Adrienne. The ventriloquist's wife said, I'll tell you why I'm divorcing my husband. Last night at a party, he embarrassed me. He threw his voice and it came out of my blank.
Bra.
Bra. Okay, Robert, she said bra.
Yeah, I don't know any people who wear them anymore. I said navel.
Navel, that's a good one.
Okay. I don't play.
Chuck?
Because I got it right.
I'm running the show.
See what an exciting image he's trying to project. I don't know anyone who wears them anymore.
Yes.
I don't know anyone who needs them anymore.
They have a pad and a convertible he drives around in. I said cleavage.
Cleavage. That's a match.
So who's six?
Okay.
Who's six?
Did you finally think of something?
I said nose.
He said nose.
Nobody knows.
My lady doesn't like
nose. Everyone knows. Okay, now Ginger, you need 4 to tie, 5 to win. Ken said, how can anybody say all people are created equal? I just saw blank standing next to Dolly Parton. Are you thinking about it?
No, I'm excellent.
Okay. Ken said, how can anybody say all people are created equal? I just saw blank standing next to Dolly Parton.
Twiggy.
Twiggy.
What did she say?
She said Twiggy.
See, I almost said Twiggy.
You almost said Twiggy.
I almost said Twiggy, but I listened to her. I said olive oil.
Olive oil.
I'm sorry, it's her fault.
Olive oil.
I told him.
Wouldn't it be funny if she calls up her card and it says Twiggy?
It'd be a riot, wouldn't it?
Yes.
I keep telling him, it's not how you play the game, it's who wins. Twiggy. Twiggy. Oh, Twiggy. Twiggy. Twiggy, it's the German pronunciation.
Right, Twiggy. Twiggy.
I went with the Mexican El Twiggo.
El Twiggo. I must say, I saw Twiggy at a party a couple of weeks ago here, and since she's had her baby, she's, yeah, it's arthritis.
You're going to be
really,
soon.
She's a very attractive woman.
Oh, yeah,
woman,
she's really
she's
nice and curvaceous and
what
sweet.
What party was that?
Her husband is cute, too. Love them both.
I said Twiggy.
That's 3. We need 1 more to tie, 2 more to win. 1 to tie and 2 to win.
I saw her. By the way, her husband has great boobs, but that's another story. Twiggy?
Tie score, 4-4. Joyce?
It's up to me.
It's up to you.
You tell him, Cher.
Whether you win.
Whether you win or lose. That was fun.
Yes.
Okay.
Now, this is the first game, right? We got another game to go. We'll see you a little bit later, Adrienne Carney. And while we're rolling her off, we're going to roll a message or two just for you. Here we go. Here we go now with Ginger Morris, who's going to have a go at the really big money here. The Super Match coming up. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Florence blank. Now, if you give us the answer that group in this studio wrote down most often, you get $500. If you match their second most popular answer, $250, then for matching the third, $100. And look at the stars and see which ones appear to have a glimmer of an idea.
Joyce?
A chair.
You wanted to say share, chair, didn't
yes,
you?
Yes, yes.
Florence Nightingale.
Florence Nightingale.
Sexy Charles.
Who?
Sexy Charles.
Sexy Charles.
Sure, they're always buttering up the guys up there.
Sylvester O'Reilly.
My Robert Redford side sleeves.
Bombed again.
Florence Henderson.
Okay.
I have to go with Robert.
You made a big mistake.
I'm with you, honey.
Florence.
Good.
Oh, good.
Zabak. No, no. Remember Florence Zabak?
That was Florian.
Oh.
F-L-O-R-I-A-N, Florian. The violinist. Florian.
No, how about Florence. Florence, Italy?
Florence, Italy. Thank you.
Thank you. Elaine. Dave, you can sit next to me.
Florence, Italy. Florence Henderson and Florence Nightingale.
Florence of Arabia.
You can Florence of Arabia.
That's what I had. I thought it sounded good.
What?
Florence Henderson.
You want Florence Henderson?
Nightingale.
The Wesson Oil Lady.
No. Nightingale.
Would you say Nightingale?
Yeah.
Okay. Gonna find out who's right and wrong here.
Probably.
Let's find
Italy.
Out what we got under the $100 number. Italy.
Come on, boy.
Was Robert Elaine's answer.
Yes.
Okay, let's take a look at the $250 number. Henderson.
I think they were right, huh?
Yeah.
Gonna turn up Nightingale, and you're probably gonna be right. You're a very smart bunch. Let's slide the big one. You're right. Okay. Now, Ginger, $2,500 is the least you can play for. However, you could be playing for $5,000 if you get a lucky spin of the star wheel. We wish you the best of luck, and let's have a go at it now. We'll all root for a double now as you give it a tug right there and make it go once, at least once around, and here we go. Pulse. It's after his wheel is stopped. It is futile to shout double. You see, the wheel is already
like
stopped.
It looks like a double from here.
That does not a double. That's called parallax.
I like what he said. He said, "Well, as long as it doesn't land on me."
And it
God
did.
God love his little heart.
Now you're gonna write your answer, and she'll give a verbal response. And here we go. Good luck to you for $2,500. Cuckoo, blank. Oh. Okay. All right, he's finished. Now, if you give us the answer that he's got on the card, we give you $2,500. What do you say to that?
Cuckoo, friend, and Ollie.
It's not Cuckoo, Fran, and Ollie. It's Kukla, Sam, and Irving. No, now listen, I know you weren't around when that was a big popular show on television. We had Kukla and Ollie on this show recently. It's Kukla, Fran, and Ollie.
Maybe she misunderstood. Maybe she misheard it.
No, I let her read the word. So, now, if Robert Walden, by any chance, says... Now, wait a minute. Now, wait. He could say it. It's possible he's got that on that card. Cuckoo, Fran, and Ollie.
If I do...
Wait,
can I come back again?
Yes.
No!
To get him to change his not to say Kukla, Fran, you didn't pay any attention.
Cuckoo, Fran, and Ollie.
I said accordion. No, I didn't. I said.
That's why it didn't work.
Cuckoo clock. Okay. Well, listen, you were a little nervous, so you says Cuckoo, Fran, and Ollie. And I'll never forget it as long as I live. Holy mackerel. Well, let's go to a commercial now, and we'll give her a drink of water and carry on here. Okay, here we are. Adrienne, welcome back. This is the second and final game. Good luck to both ladies. We'll begin with you. You may have A or B.
B, please.
B it is. Are you ready?
Yes.
Beverly Hills is really ritzy.
How ritzy is it?
It's really ritzy. The kids still write on the walls, but they do it in blank. Perfect.
You're smart.
Okay, Adrienne. Beverly Hills is really ritzy. The kids still write on the walls, but they do it in...
Only thing I can think of is gold.
Gold! That's a good answer. Send it. What did you say there, Robert? You said gold.
I said in oils.
Yes,
oils.
A portrait painter would do in oils.
Oil,
yeah.
Oils.
Yes. No, not that. That's not a bad answer. Oils, you see. Oils is not bad. See, the kids who deface subway cars and do the vandalism, they get cans of spray paint and cheap paint, you know, but oil paint would be expensive.
No, he's talking about oil.
Then it's a rotten answer. Let's all boo in unison. Okay, thank you.
It's obtuse.
Okay, now I don't want an argument with this. Remember, I was cranky earlier today.
You're not going to be cranky anymore.
I said gold-tipped Crayolas.
Gold-tipped Crayolas. There it is. Gold. Little gold, Charles?
No, I said green and red of Gucci fame.
Green and red of Gucci fame. Gucci.
And stinks.
Still right on the walls, but they do it in, Elaine?
Gold leafing.
Gold leafing is very good. You made a paper, Adrienne? Paper, Adrienne?
Well, I said they still do it, but they do it by a north light.
What does that mean?
It says north light on that card. I saw it myself. Artists paint by the north light, and that's what he had in mind there.
I understood that.
You and me, Bill.
Okay.
I said they do it in, not in the subway, not in the John, they do it in Gucci's.
In Gucci's. All right. But they do it in Gucci's, huh?
Well,
okay. Ginger, you ready? She got two on hers. That's not bad. Steve said, that new plane I flew in was so big.
How big was it?
Getting better. When I asked the stewardess if I could visit first class, she handed me a blank. That's how big the plane was.
What is it again?
What's the operative word?
A big airplane. I asked the stewardess if I could visit first class. She handed me a blank.
I'm finished, Bill. I got all ten.
A couple of two or three really good answers here. Two that I can think of.
What are we going to do? Such a pretty old thing.
Did you hear that over there? Did you hear that? Nobody heard it. Okay. But Robert said a possible answer out loud, and I thought maybe someone might have heard it. Okay, Bill, you ready?
Yeah, okay.
Steve said, that new plane I flew in was so big, when I asked the stewardess if I could visit first class, she handed me a...
A parachute.
A parachute. She obviously didn't hear your answer,
no.
Bob. Okay, a parachute. Now, I think you missed the point there. It was a very large airplane, and we're going for a little humor here. What do you say?
I said a visa.
Visa.
Handed me a visa.
That's a good answer. Go from one part to another.
Oh, no. Like, what we all do in Beverly Hills. Had him a skateboard.
Skateboard. Okay.
They love my answer. Those are my people.
Right. Hey, passport.
Passport is very good, too. All three were good answers.
That's better.
Now what we got down here?
I was going to say a pair of car keys, but I didn't think it was that large, so I stuck with transfer.
Transfer. That's another possibility.
That's in New York.
She gave another ticket on another airline to fly there. Got the first class.
It's still got...
Oh.
Hit that
not
man.
Not a bad roll. Yes. Not a Danish roll.
Is that the paperback version?
Keep that for another show.
Okay. What do you say there, Joyce?
Well, I'm worried about Bill.
No.
I said a transfer.
A transfer. So no parachutes occurred there at all. Now, you two ladies stand by because we've got a commercial for you. I thank you, stars. I'm Gene Rayburn. Join us next time for Match Game. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are beautiful bath faucets and polished satin chrome and natural onyx inserts and dependable valvette system. Kohler faucets, the tradition of quality and craftsmanship. And Zero shirts, the ultimate in classic design, featuring the celebrated purest button-down, luxurious fabrics, distinctive pattern, Zero. Nothing is obvious except the quality. And a grill and Eskimo pie. Dairy fresh vanilla ice cream covered with special chocolate flavor coating. Eskimo pie, refreshing and delicious anytime for an old-fresh treat. And Blue Luster Shampoo and Blue Luster Plus Carpet Shampoo and Grease Cutters and Brightness to remove ground-in dirt and grime. And an 11-piece manicure set and the only solution, new family health concept, one conditioner for both hair and skin, is the only solution worth trying. And from Hawaiian Tropic comes an attractive beach mat and Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils. Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the islands. And a frying pan and Hollywood Safflower Oil, higher in polyunsaturates and other oils. Hollywood Safflower Oil contains no cholesterol. From Hollywood Foods. Production. This program was edited for broadcast.